Hey, this is Seth, and in this short video, I'm going to share with you the differences between my digital marketing career program and Course Career's digital marketing career program. Now, right off the bat, I want to let you know, I'm actually a big fan of Course Career's, and I'm a colleague of Troy who founded Course Career's. I love their vision of a world in which young people can get marketable skills directly and affordably and start careers quickly without college. That's very similar to my vision. And Troy and Course Careers has been helping people achieve that dream in many fields, just not digital marketing. So I'm going to explain more about what I mean in a moment. But first, if you like this video and this content, please remember to like it and subscribe to get more career advice videos. I'm making a lot more of them these days, and I really appreciate your support. So what do I mean when I say they've been helping people in a lot of other fields other than digital marketing? Well, tech sales, okay, is a huge, huge success for Course Careers. Technology sales is actually a great industry to get into. There are a lot of success stories. He also teaches people how to get into information technology, software development, data analytics, UX, human resources. But if you look at their homepage, digital advertising is at the very bottom. And there's a reason for that. It's because the program just doesn't have the same results as some of their other programs. If you go here to student stories, or if you go over to their YouTube page, you're going to see a ton of testimonials for tech sales. Tech sales. Great results in tech sales. No question. And if you guys want a career in tech sales, go to Course Careers. But what about digital marketing? If you look for their testimonials on digital marketing, there is one testimonial, and it's from last year with a guy who isn't even the current instructor. So I think that's something to just ask about. If you're talking the Course Careers and you're wondering about it, say, ask them, like, where are the success stories? Because tech sales has so many and digital marketing has so few. Now, when I'm shopping for things, I think testimonials are very important. That's why I have so many interviews. If you look at my channel, you know, I've been doing my course since 2016. We have 134 videos on YouTube alone. If you go over to Instagram, you're gonna see hundreds, I think there's 300-400. Then these are real people that you can reach out to on LinkedIn and talk to. And I wanted to point something else out of it, just about my program, is that not everybody, first of all, very few people, percentage-wise, want to be interviewed on YouTube. That's why there's so many more Instagram than YouTube posts. But then there's people like Narek here. Hold on, this is inside my Facebook group. I remember he said, I didn't even mention it, but I got a PPC job early last year. And he didn't, I just think, he's been working for a year, and he didn't even tell me about it. So there's a lot of that. Now, if that's happening with Course Careers, you should ask them about it, because I think they've been so good at posting their tech sales testimonials, I would think that they would have some more digital marketing testimonials. So that's not to say that this isn't a good program, but I would just say the goal of my course is to get you a job. So if I was selling this, like, they're selling you on a great opportunity, but what are the results? And I don't see any. If you look at the quality of the course itself, I imagine it's a good course. And by the way, if you're comparing Course Careers to like any of the other boot camps out there that are charging so much money, thousands of dollars, his course is also very affordably priced. So, and the person, the instructor, Brendan, I looked him up on LinkedIn. He looks like a good dude who has got a lot of good experience. So I imagine that he's put together a good program. The program outline, from what I'm seeing, is similar to mine. You know, in my program, we start out with the basics. We give you an introduction, which is what they're doing here. They're giving, like, orienting you. I do a lot of stuff on mindset. And I teach, and we also have alumni advice videos, which is cool because, again, we've had so many successes. I had a lot of my alumni put together videos giving advice on how to do the course, what to look out for, what it's like to work in the field, and things like that. And then I teach people about a digital funnel, Google Ads. This is really the heart of it, Google Ads. There's so much information in there. Google Analytics, SEO, Facebook Ads, email marketing, and then how to generate your experience, get clients, and then how to put that experience on your resume in such a way that it's compelling to hiring managers. And if you look at their curriculum, it's similar. They're teaching you about the advertising process, different channels, and then they're teaching you paid search, Google Ads, paid social, which is Facebook, and analytics, and interview prep. But again, if this is effective, I want to see more results. Now, they had a different instructor last year, the guy from Rich and Niche, who is also a great guy. But it's been more than a year than this program's been out, and I don't see the results. So there is, you know, a difference between being good at digital marketing and being able to teach people how to get a job in digital marketing, which is what I do. The other thing I wanted to point out is that in this program, you do not learn SEO. Now, when people start out in my course in digital marketing, as they say here, it's fundamentals. You don't know anything about digital marketing. Some people are drawn to paid search and other people do not like it and they really love SEO. And if you look at my testimonials here, you see there's hundreds of them. You're gonna see about half of these students, I don't know exactly, it could be 60-40, but a lot of them are working in paid search and a lot of them are working in SEO. SEO is like the second most in-demand, high-paying skill set out there. And in my opinion, I say if you want to have the best shot of having a fulfilling career in digital marketing, you need to learn both. And what happens is people say, well, which one do I choose? Within my course, once you learn the basics, which is what I teach, and you start doing your projects, you will get a sense very quickly of which one you like more. And I think not having SEO as part of the program, it's just, you know, again, you're giving yourself fewer options for employment. The other thing is the community. Now it says here, robust community, become part of our community with access to our student-only Discord server. And I think it's great to have a Discord. We've tried Discord, but we found that Facebook group is just, there's a lot more. As you can see, there's just a lot of interaction on the Facebook group. Most people's posts are getting a lot of responses, whether it's a success story or whether it's somebody asking for a question. People are very supportive. People want to know, you know, want to share when they get a certification. And there's a lot of engagement in the Facebook group. But what we also have that I don't see in Course Careers is coaching calls. Twice a week, you actually get on a Zoom call with my coaches. And these coaches are people working in the industry in SEO and PPC. There's an SEO and a PPC call each week. Now, even if you're not so interested in PPC, you still get value from the SEO call. You can see we have coaching calls twice a week, Wednesdays and Saturdays, to try to make it so that people who are international can also show up on the calls. And, you know, everyone has a different work schedule, but we found Wednesday night, Saturday afternoon usually works out pretty good. We've got Nick and Ivy. Nick works in PPC, and he's been, you know, managing millions of dollars of ad spend for the last 6 years. He used to work at Metro PCS. He was one of my earliest success stories, and now he's just so experienced and has so much insight to give to you guys. Ivy works for Crate and Barrel. She does SEO, making great money, working for a $1 billion corporation. And these are the type of networking opportunities that people go to college for, but they don't get them because the people teaching them in college don't teach digital. So you're getting actual FaceTime with professionals working in the industry. And also within the members area, you can see I have archived a whole bunch of these calls from 2023, 2022, 2021, going all the way back. And there's literally hundreds of hours of conversations. And I have a timestamp document, so you can actually like sort of skim through it and see if another student had a question that you have. I wouldn't suggest that you look at every one of these videos, but it's nice to know there's a library available. It's just a lot. Again, we have a lot of history in the course. Whereas, again, I think it's great that they have a Discord. Again, I just don't know how robust it is. And I don't see the proof. And the last thing I was gonna say is, guys, this certificate of completion thing is a waste of time. I don't offer one because employers don't care about it. If you put a certificate of completion on your LinkedIn, it doesn't show that you know how to actually do the job. And again, these programs that don't have the results I have will offer these certificates. I don't offer a certificate. I'd rather show people, you know, like James here getting hired, I just randomly clicked on this, but he's 17 years old and got a $70,000 a year job. I think he's 18 now. I don't know when this was posted, but you know, 6 weeks from the course, I got my first job offer. Andy, I mean, there's just, you know, you can just see proof, so much proof. I am constantly posting new testimonials. If you go, especially on Instagram, see Samara did this interview. This is for the interview with John, Nicole, Tracy, Alex, Amy, Dan. Like, you're gonna see regularly updated testimonials on YouTube and Instagram all the time. So that's another thing to look for, is like how up to date are things. I know because I have videos that go all the way back to like 2017, 2018, I've heard people say, oh, are things up to date? Because they saw an older interview. And I said, well, just look at the most recent proof, and they're always coming in. I just interviewed somebody. I'm interviewing somebody on Wednesday. People are always getting jobs, so I'm always doing interviews. So that's what I'd be looking for. And again, you know, Troy is really good at doing that with the tech sales side of things. I just, again, haven't seen that on the digital marketing side of things, which is why I'm still advocating my course. I hope this was helpful. Whichever path you take, I wish you to get marketable skills and get into a career that you love. If you have any questions for me or comments, you can leave them below this video. You can click the link below this video to see my webinar, how to get a $60,000 a year remote job with no previous experience or education, or click the other link to learn more about my full training. I answer questions from students every day. You can go to my YouTube channel, find the LinkedIn for my students. Like, here's John, and he gives, you can actually go and click on his LinkedIn and ask him questions. And then go to Course Careers if you really want to work with them and ask them those questions. Just say, can you tell us about some, testimonials? Give us more information. Why aren't you guys teaching SEO? Just ask them the questions, and hopefully they'll have a good answer for you. But again, whichever path you choose, I wish you the very best. Thanks for hanging out, and I'll see you in the next video.